You try to, in the earliest stages, look like every other startup on paper. The one place you don't want to innovate in these early days is really in the law. And when you go out to reach and connect with venture investors, seed investors, you know, the one thing they don't want to have to address shortly after an investment is spending a lot of those precious early dollars effectively cleaning up a big corporate legal mess. Ideally, when you approach an investor, you're able to go to them and say, I'm represented by a law firm that works frequently with technology companies, a firm like Fenwick & West. And our objective is to help you have a corporate structure and corporate documents that investors can look at and say, great, this is all standard. You'll notice that the investor's overall stress level decreases dramatically from, like the joke, DEFCON 5 to DEFCON 1. By simply saying, listen, I've got standard market terms, and as a result, you know, you're going to come in and hit the ground running and put those seed dollars to work where they need to be, which is in helping you grow the team and push the business forward. You definitely want to be disruptive and creative in your technology, your platform. I mean, venture investors and seed investors and entrepreneurs, it's all about creating new market opportunities, about establishing disruptive technologies. But when it comes to legal, just keep it simple. If you look at all the great companies in Silicon Valley and technology history, you'll notice that they really incented their people. They really worked hard together to make sure everyone was rowing in the same direction. If the range from an equity grant perspective, for example, was a quarter of a point to a third of a point because this was some rock star engineer or some really key hire, you saw these successful founders in these great companies, they would err on the side of being more generous. So within that bounds of reason, and I'm not suggesting go out and give away non-market equity grants or out of market salary comp packages, but what I'm saying, within the bounds of reason, you know, err on the side of being more generous to your team. And by doing that, I really think it creates the right incentives. It's really a fundamental ingredient for success. And so by following these two guiding principles, believe it or not, in the earliest stages, keeping it simple on the legal side, not trying to innovate in the law, looking like, you know, your typical startup on paper, and coupling that with being generous to your team, you'll find that answers 90+% of your questions in the early days.